And when it gets this hot, we really need to think about our pets too. But even with the best of intentions, you might be making mistakes you don't even realize. And 13 Action News anchor Zora Asbury has some things you should keep in mind.
With temperatures in the triple digits, it's super important to make sure you take care of your pets outside, know when to walk them, when to make sure that they have water, and you always want to make sure to protect those paws.
Would you walk barefoot on the pavement in Las Vegas peak heat? Your dog will never turn down a walk, so Pawtastic friend LV says you need to play it smart this summer.
Please do not let your dogs walk outside when it's super hot. Their pads on their paws are very susceptible to getting burned and injured, and it's just not worth it.
Novelli says the best time to go for a walk is either early in the morning or late at night.
When the sun is down and you know the pavement's not so hot, what we say is feel the pavement. If the pavement's too hot for your hand, it's too hot for their paws. Hi, buddy. There you go.
One thing to note is that some breeds physically cannot handle high temperatures.
Like bulldogs and smaller dogs or a big dog and a smaller dog body, they have a harder time, cooling down.
Pet experts also say it's best to keep your dog in a cool space, preferably inside your home. But if you have an outdoor dog, Novelli says it's vital you keep them cool.
Mister, shades, a lot of water. I mean, the whole outside dog thing kind of drives us nuts, but give the dog as much shade and water as possible.
Just this year, lawmakers made it illegal to tether or restrain a dog during a heat advisory. It's also against the law for a dog to be tethered outside of their home for more than 10 hours in a 24-hour window. Lastly, as a result of Lilly's Law, temperature restrictions are now in place on days where temps reach 105 or higher. Pet owners now required to implement cooling devices for pets placed outdoors. Reporting, Zora Asbury, 13 Action News.